In 1962, here in Centralia, Pennsylvania, they decided to reduce the amount of garbage in their landfill by burning it. What they didn't realize is that by lighting this garbage pile, they would ignite a fire that would still burn to this day, one that would turn Centralia into a ghost town. Now, this used to be a neighborhood, but it's not the fire that destroyed it. I mean, the fire's never even touched the surface. That's because the fire is entirely underground. I'm Jake, and this is Extreme Science. Centralia was born a coal town. The first mines were opened in the 1850s. By 1890, over 2,700 people lived here, drawn by the vast wealth of coal underground. Then 1962 rolled around. The garbage fire lit a coal mine seam, and that seam spread through the tunnels beneath the town. The fire itself can get up to 1,350 degrees Fahrenheit, and it can heat the surface to 900 degrees, enough to melt lead. And also, there are holes all over the ground here. You actually feel the heat radiating from it. It's really cool. Well, it's actually kind of hot. But also every year the fire spreads 50 to 75 feet, and with it the ground starts to give way. The Department of Transportation had to shut down 4,000 feet of highway because the fire was weakening the ground supporting it. But the fire wasn't the only problem. The toxic gas it was releasing was much more threatening. On Valentine's Day in 1981, a child was walking through some neighbors' backyards when a 140-foot sinkhole opened up beneath him. He was exposed to carbon monoxide levels 30 times the safe amount. He survived, but what made it scary is that it could have been anyone's kid at any time in any part of town. After that, the US government gave $42 million to relocate the citizens of Centralia. But the obvious question is, why hasn't anyone tried to put it out? Well, they have. They've tried flushing out with water, but it just flared back up. They even installed air vents to try and direct the fire away from the town, but nothing worked, because underground there is a very special kind of coal, anthracite coal. Coal is made up primarily of carbon. You and I are 18% carbon, plants are 45%, then black coal is 60% to 80%. Anthracite coal is 97% carbon, more than any kind of coal, meaning it can burn for longer. Over 40% of the world's electricity is from coal. Every day, 6.5 pounds of it is burned worldwide, per person. In 2010, the US burned over 1 billion tons of coal, about the weight of 2,877 Empire State Buildings. This anthracite mine is a few miles away from the one in Centralia that is currently burning. And when coal burns, a few things happen. Energy is released, yes, but also released with it are particulates, little floating pieces of coal that the World Health Organization says causes 1 million deaths a year. Also released are toxins and chemicals like arsenic, sulfur, nitrogen, and of course, CO2. Out of the 35 billion metric tons of CO2 created each year from fossil fuels, 50% of that is from coal. The CO2 acts as an insulator, trapping the sun's reflected heat and raising global temperatures. There have been attempts to make coal cleaner, more environmentally friendly, but nothing yet is feasible. Now, trees absorb CO2. Each individual tree can take about 4.8 pounds of it, but we'd need 1.5 billion of them per power plant. The other option is an alternate source of energy. Iceland. Puffins, glaciers, black beaches, and geothermal energy. 25% of their power is geothermal. Or take Burlington, Vermont, which runs entirely on renewable energy. 10% of energy production in the US is renewable. Things like hydropower, wind, solar, and geothermal. And it is incredible, but to get off coal completely, that rather small percentage needs to get much bigger, much more quickly. Which brings us back to Centralia. This town can be used not just as an example of what coal can do to a community, but on a larger scale, what coal can do to our planet. Because it wasn't the fire that destroyed the town, it was what the fire released, those toxic chemicals and gases, the potential for something worse. It is estimated that in 100 to 250 years, the fire will finally die out. And hopefully by then, we will have moved to renewable energy, if not sooner. Which means that the fire burning underneath us in Centralia, that anthracite coal, might just be the last coal to ever burn. I'm Jake, and I'll see you next time on Extreme Science.